snakes in particular change a lot in size and color as they grow. So today, I'm gonna show you some comparisons between babies and adult corn snakes. So let's get to it. So let's be honest, the title to this video is a little bit silly, but what I'm trying to do is do different things in order to get people watching, because we have over 6,000 subscribers and some videos were only getting like 500 views. So I put a lot of time into the videos, so I wanna reach as much people as possible. So if you could, what could also help is give this a thumbs up and drop a comment down below. That will feed the algorithm and help us reach more people. It would be so greatly appreciated, and I look forward to hearing your guys' feedback about this video. So let's get into it. So how about we start out with the full adult size of a corn snake. This here is an adult male. And now, unlike other species of snake, especially most python species, males in corn snakes are actually larger than females. So this male is a full-grown male. He bred this year. He's probably about 5 years old. He is one of our bigger individuals. Keep in mind that the more you feed a snake, the larger it will get. And now that is not to encourage you to overfeed your snake, because quite frankly, just like in humans, an overweight snake is a very unhealthy snake. So it's always important to make sure that your snake is a healthy weight, a way you can tell. When they get a little bit overweight, the scales will start to separate and you will get this white in between the scales, and you can tell that that animal is a little bit too obese. But this is a very typical size for an adult male corn snake. Now let's take his mate from this year as an example. This female is quite a bit smaller than he is, but she is an adult female and she did produce eggs this year. Now keep in mind, like I said before, as much as you feed them is as much as they grow, and she is a little bit of a smaller individual, but then again, she is still an adult female. This is a very, very easy snake to keep, quite frankly. They're only getting, you know, maybe on the large side, 4 to 5 feet. You may get an occasional 6 foot animal, but honestly, that is probably an animal that is way overfed. I find it much more common for them to be about this size, which is probably under 3 feet. But let's go in a little bit of how much they change from babies to adults. Now, how about this for a color change and size change? So this is a baby that we produced this year. This is a product of this mother right here. And as you can see, it will look much more like her as an adult. You can see that it is an orangish red color, but it's just not even close to as saturated as the oranges on this adult female. So it's awesome watching these guys grow, because they do kind of change colors all the time. And you don't necessarily know what they're gonna look like as adults, as babies. But when you have amazing looking animals to start off with, you usually end up with amazing looking babies and amazing looking adults. But you'll see animals that maybe aren't so stunning as babies turn out to be really, really stunning adults. And I think that this one is gonna be a case of that. I can't wait to see what happens when they grow up. Looks pretty normal, pretty average baby right now, but just wait until he gets the age of this girl right here. And just check out the size difference. Corn snakes come out so little. And keep in mind that this is about a 3-month-old baby. It's not even a baby right out of the egg, but you can see them just hanging out there. Obviously, they're not going to interact with each other or anything like that. It's not like corn snakes take care of their young or anything, but it's cool to take them out just to get a comparison of their size. Check out just how chill this little girl is. This here is an AML buff. And these guys are a few months old now, but let's take a look at mom. So amel means amelanistic, which means lacking in melanin or the black pigment in the snake. So it leaves your corn snake with this orangey look, but buff is a yellow enhancing gene that actually brings out more of that orange. You know, these here are the saddle patterns, and you may see some amels with some pretty red saddles. The buff will actually make them a very cool creamy orange color, and then the ground coloration will be much more yellow. But as you can see, as babies, it's hard to imagine that that ground color comes in yellow like that, because it's so faded out whitish color. And then the saddles on the babies are actually pretty orange as babies. Where I see the orange the most is actually on the head pattern as babies, which makes it a little bit easier for me to pick these out from regular amels. But I'd say mom did a good job here. So I kind of wanted to interrupt right now because our little guy, I call this guy Ripper. He is from our Miami Okeetee clutch, but he's an Annery Miami Okeetee. So Miami actually washes out that coloration, makes it more of a, you know, black and white is really, really hard to achieve in corn snakes, but we're gonna try to achieve it to the best of our ability. Most of the regular Anneries aren't very black and white coloration, but this guy is pretty much as close as we've gotten so far. And I forgot to show you guys him in the last video, and I really, really wanted to get you guys a look at this guy because I think he is just so amazing. He has a crazy zigzag pattern going down his back and just one of my favorite corn snakes that I've ever produced. Now this here is a ghost corn snake, which is the product of an Annery and a hypo corn snake. Now this is one of my favorite simple combinations because in my opinion you can't go wrong with a cool slate gray and purple snake. And let's look at the little baby from this girl. So here we are. Here is the little girl, the baby of this female that I have right here. As you can see, she's actually influenced from her coral father. So coral is that pink that's in the animal, and it's actually produced by this thing called red factor. So the male had red factor and ghost in him. We bred him with this female that does not have red factor. So we ended up with a little bit more high pink animals, and let's get a closer look at this little guy. The pink is really, really coming in on the sides there and on the, coming up a little bit through the saddles, and it will start intensifying as this guy gets older. It's such a beautiful snake, and it will look even better when it's an adult. That's the cool thing about corn snakes in comparison to a lot of other species, is that they actually get better with age. Instead, things like ball pythons, typically most mutations get drabber with age. Corn snakes tend to saturate their color more, and they tend to get more beautiful with age. Now, I just believe that there's something super special about this combination here. This is Amel Diffused Caramel, or it's known by a shorter name, which is called Sulfur. And as you can see, they just end up being these awesome yellowish orange adults. It's hard to even get across what color this is. I don't know if it shows up that great in camera. And they end up with these cool diffused heads. And let's check out the baby, because the baby is so drastically different from this animal right here. It's so interesting. So like most of the other babies that you saw, it's gonna start off a lot less saturated. So this baby is more of a light ground yellowish color, but not anywhere close to the yellow color that's exhibited in the female. It's more white and orange than yellow and orange. So, and as you can see, this one in particular just has almost no head pattern. There's barely just a little bit of orange on the head, and such a beautiful baby here. I just love the way that they look as babies, and I love the way that they look as adults. It's basically like having two different snakes, even though they have the same genes in them, because there's just such a drastic difference between the baby and the adult. So I believe that this morph is like super underrated, because when you're buying a baby, it looks totally different as it does from an adult. So that's part of the fun, is seeing how they progress and then seeing what they turn out to be. So this here is the Sulfur corn snake. There you go, there's a good picture of that head. Amazing little snake. All right, you get this girl out of here. Come on, girl. Okay. Oh, there you go. Boom. Now, here is our girl, mother of McDonald's. So she was actually named after her son because we named her son McDonald. I still have him right down here. So we're gonna get to see what they look like from adult to about a year and a half, and then we'll show you a baby. So this here is McDonald. And as you can see, he's not exactly as red and yellow as he was as a baby, but he still looks great. A lot of my Ultramel Tesseras and a lot of my Ultramels in general turn into pretty orange animals now. And now Ultramels can look a little bit different depending on where they're coming from, but mine tend to have this Home Depot type of look to them. That's what I call Home Depot orange. And let's check out what one of the little babies looks like. And here we go. This is a little baby. it's gonna be hard for me to hold all three of them. But so as you can see, they actually don't change as much as a lot of the other mutations in corn snakes. So this baby actually looks a lot more like the mom. And McDonald is obviously a little bit more yellow, but this is one of the smallest changes that we see in morphs as far as corn snakes go. But they're all beautiful animals. Obviously there's Tessera in here and Ultramel. So Tessera is kind of a wild card as far as, you know, really whacks out that pattern, really makes some beautiful, beautiful animals. Obviously Tessera is probably my favorite mutation to use as of the moment besides Palmetto, which is coming in the future. But I just love the wacky, wacky patterns that it provides. Now there is variability between the mutations as corn snakes come out, so not every A-male is going to look exactly the same. And so when I get animals that are, say, really, really high contrast, like this girl here, I try to hold on to them as much as I can. And let's check out its mother. So of course, when you wanna show off snakes, they're in shed. So the mother is in shed, but as you can see, beautiful reds and oranges. She is a little bit more high contrast usually when she's shed, but you'll see that the A-males tend to pretty much change the least in comparison to a lot of the other mutations. But ultimately, I mean, they are not very similar as far as the look goes. This one looks very red and white as a baby, and that ground coloration will probably orange out a bit more like this girl does. So Tessera is in these guys as well, which is why the pattern's all whacked out, but you can see mother and baby size difference right there. These babies are about 2 months old or so. So they got a little bit to go, huh? Look at them. So cool. So now you can see the female is actually doing this little twitching motion. So this is a territorial response. So that's why I wouldn't really keep corn snakes together ever. You know, you always get people saying, let's cohab them, do this, do that. Listen, you can do that if you have a lot of space, a lot of hot spots, a lot of different places for them to get away from each other. But nobody who's keeping these as pets will really be able or willing to drop that kind of enclosure, make that kind of enclosure that would allow them the proper space to cohabitate or live together. So please just keep your corn snakes separate. Now, one of our really popular babies is our honey corn snakes. Now, I wanted to get the mother or the father out, but they are both in shed. And I don't just mean like in shed, I mean like they just look brown at this point. They are very, very deep in shed, so maybe I'll put a little picture somewhere over here so you guys can see what they look like as adults, because it is one of the most dramatic changes of the babies, and I was really looking forward to showing you guys it. But we can at least show you one of our little babies. They start out even more drab than this. This is on about the third shed, and every single shed, they just get a little bit brighter, a little bit more yellow, a little bit more contrast between the saddle pattern and the ground pattern, and just turn into beautiful yellow adults. So sorry I didn't get the adult honey, but it would not be a good representation of what they look like. And of course, I wanna thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that kind of cleared up some questions about sizes and if males are bigger than females, what breeding size is. So all those animals that you saw, all the adults that I was holding, were breeding size, and those are animals that produced last year, if not the year before or the year before that. And I have a bunch more animals that are kind of coming up on deck to breeding size, so there'll be even more projects coming in the future. Now, we still have a few of these animals available. We do have Gaps Eco Coco Core, the Coco Core that I use on the Amazon enclosure, so we do have that available on our website if you want to check that out real quick. And like I said before, like, comment, subscribe. And if you made it this far, you're on the team.